characteristic of the coordinate geometry, and today we are moving forward. Means yesterday we are seeing how, what is coordinate geometry, what is mean by coordinate, how to solve the examples, which types of examples can be asked. All this we are seeing yesterday. So today we are going to see different types of examples which can be asked. Obviously, we are going to see how for how many marks the question will be asked, and if it asks, how we have to solve that question. So let's start with this. Okay, so let's see the first question. It is very easy, students. We have already seen yesterday. The same says, state in which quadrant or which axis do the following point lie? Right? What is state? In which quadrant or on which axis do the following points lie? You know this very well, students. Look here. I am having here this this quadrant we are having. Few of the points are given to us, and we have to identify that in which quadrant or which axis do lie. If I look at the first one, it is F15, minus 18. You know very well that the first point indicates, the first point indicates x coordinate, and second indicates the y coordinate. So here in F15, 15 belongs to this x-axis, means it belongs to the 15, that is x coordinate is positive, then y quadrant is minus. We don't have to consider the numbers, we just have to concentrate on the signs, with positive and the negative signs. So here minus 18, there's minus, where if you find minus, that is y coordinate minus is here, that means x coordinate is positive, y coordinate coordinate is negative, that means this point F15 minus 18, this is lying in quadrant number 4. Here we have to just remember on which quadrant which axis is positive, where x coordinate is positive or whether y coordinate is positive. Accordingly, we are going to identify that where it will lie. Now next is E3735. Again, we don't have to consider the numbers, just concentrate on the signs. Both are the positive. Yes, x is positive, y is positive. So look here, where is x positive? X is positive in first quadrant. Same way, y is also positive on the first quadrant, means in first quadrant, both x and y are positive. Therefore, this one, point E, will definitely lie in first quadrant. Dear student, it is very, very easy. Now next one, M120, look here. One of the coordinate is zero, and you know very well that the coordinate which is zero, that means the we don't have any point on that coordinate. Look, M12, x coordinate is given, y coordinate is zero, that is definitely that it is lying on axis. On which axis it is lying? Since y coordinate is zero, it is lying on x axis. Make it very clear, student. If y coordinate is zero, the point will lie on x-axis. If x coordinate is zero, the point will lie on y-axis. Now, can anyone tell me about this P0 2.5? Here, y coordinate is zero. X coordinate is zero, and y coordinate is given to us. So, can anyone answer on which quadrant will this lie? Yes, who is this? Sakshi Maurya. Okay. Dinkar Tiwari. Yes. Dinkar, where it will lie?
Y-axis.
Very good. Since your x-coordinate is zero, this point is going to lie on y-axis. Next, point Q. Where it will lie, Sakshi? Both are negative.
Miss, which question you have asked?
Yes, point Q. Where it will lie?
It will lie in the third quadrant.
Very good. It will lie in quadrant number 3. Look here, student. What is here? In Q minus 7 minus 3, x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is negative. Where we find both are negative, look here. In third quadrant, quadrant number 3, y are negative, x is negative. So, therefore, this will lie in x coordinate. This will lie in quadrant number 3. So, it is lying on y-axis, and it is lying in third quadrant. So it is very easy, student. Hope so you understood this very well. So this type of question we're going to ask just for simply 1 or 2 marks. How many points you are asked, accordingly the question, the marks to the question will increase. Now, the next question. In which quadrant are the following points? Now here, only you are given a wording and you have to identify in which quadrant this will lie. What is says whose both coordinates are positive? Where you find? Yes, Shivam. Shivam want to answer, I think. Yes, Shivam. Whose both coordinates are positive?
First quadrant.
Very good. It will lie in the first quadrant. We are having here the graph also. Look properly. Those who are not getting, in the first quadrant, if you look properly, all the values of x are positive. This is your x-axis. That means these are your x-coordinates. All your x-coordinates are positive. Then if you look at this y-axis, this here, all the y-coordinates are positive. C's both are positive. So where it is coming? Here coming to this side. Therefore, both coordinates are positive. It is lying, it will lie in the first quadrant. So it is lying in quadrant number first. Next, what is the next? Whose x coordinate is negative and y coordinate is positive? Yes, who's going to answer this one? Dinkar, Shivam, Pooja. Okay, now Pooja will answer this one. 1 second, where is Pooja? Pooja, okay. Anyone else other than this same students?
Miss, in the second quadrant.
In the second quadrant. Okay. X is negative. X is negative. Y is positive. Very good. Look here. All the values of X is negative and values of Y are positive. That means this point is going to lie in the second quadrant. So clear, everyone? It is very easy. Just remember this thing. This type of questions are going to ask in coordinate geometry. So it is very, very easy and one of the very scoring lesson. So just keep this thing in mind and you can score very good marks. So next one. Draw the coordinate system on a plane and plot the following points. Remember, student, what is said? Draw the coordinate system on a plane. You're not asked to draw on a graph paper. Plane means simply on your notebook you can draw this. And what it says? Plot the following points. Few points are given to us and we have to plot these points. How to do this? The first thing, coordinate system is what, students? Can anyone say me this coordinate system? Yes, anyone? What is mean by coordinate system? Can I ask this, Krish? No? Anyone? Okay, no problem. Coordinate system is whatever we draw, that XY plane. Yes, and someone want to, Anam. Anam, no? Okay, coordinate system means whatever we draw on the X coordinate and Y coordinate, that XY line. The two mutually perpendicular axes. That system is simply called as the coordinate system. And this we are going to draw on a plane and we have to plot this following points. Look, it is -2, 4. Let's see, we can draw any point. This is a coordinate system. If you look properly, I have not drawn this on a graph paper. I have simply drawn it on a plain paper. Therefore, we say that on a plane, not on a graph paper. A few points are given to us. Now let's draw. Now this you know very well, okay? The first point is L -2, 4. -2. First coordinate represents the coordinate of x-axis, right? That means the coordinate of x. What is that? -2. Where is -2? On x, first. That this is -2. Next is what? 4. Where is 4? Here is 4. That means it is going to lie somewhere here. Okay, let me draw this. This is from 2, I'm drawing a straight line. Suppose I draw a straight line up to this. We have to draw a line. By mistake, I have taken a segment here, but we have to draw a line. Okay, from -2, I drawn one straight line. Now your y coordinate was 4. So from this 4, I'm drawing again a straight line, which will intersect this earlier line. And where it will intersect, that is nothing but our required point. Okay, so which is that required point? That point is our F. So, kya tha ye point? F is -2, 4. So, clear how to draw this? It is very, very easy, student. Firstly, from x coordinate, draw a straight line passing through that point. Then from y axis, draw a straight line passing from given point, and where this two line meets, that will be our required point here. Okay. Now, what is the next one? Next is M5U6. The first coordinate, where is x coordinate? Here is 5U. So from 5U, I am drawing a straight line. So from 5U, I have drawn a straight line. Then next is, let me extend this. 6 is your y axis. So from this y coordinate, I am drawing a nothing but our required point. Which is that point? That point is M here. This is our point M. Clear, everyone, student? Very easy. 5, 6. Okay. Sorry for the disturbance, student. The network issue was there. Hope so this year I understood very well. Now one more question we are going to see here. Okay, then S70. What is saying? Only x coordinate is given to us. Where, what is that x coordinate? That is 7. And 0 is given to us. That means y coordinate is not given to us. So where that point will lie? That point will lie only at this point 7. That is, this is your point 7. S0. Since y coordinate is 0, the point is lying on x-axis. Okay. Hope so you understood this very well. Now let's see the next. Okay, now there are two types of a graph here. Lines parallel to x-axis, or what will be the equation of line which is parallel to x-axis? What do you say? Line parallel to x-axis. Just look at this. Consider a few sets of points. Coordinates, it is A13, B43, C-23, D03, E23. What it says, if you look properly, in each of this point, our y coordinate is constant. Yes, since your y coordinate is constant, we say that the equation of line is parallel to x-axis. X-axis, and y is equals to 3. Remember this thing, student, very well. If y coordinate is constant, the equation of line will be parallel to x-axis. And whatever the constant point is given to us, that will be your equation of line. That is y is equals to 3. Look here. What is given? I'm drawing a few points here. In each point, y coordinate is constant. Yeah, the first point, suppose first was 2, 3. So first point will come here, 2, 3. Next is suppose minus 3 and 3. So if from this I'm drawing minus, the point will lie somewhere here. Then next point is suppose minus 2. 3, that is x coordinate minus 2, again y coordinate constant 3. Then suppose one more point we are taking, x 5u 3, that is x coordinate is 5u, y coordinate is 3. So it is here. And if I am going to draw the graph of this line, so what will happen? This graph is actually, the points are pass, the line will pass from all the points, and this line is actually parallel to x-axis. Yes, parallel to x-axis means what? They will never meet each other. Here, what is this? If y coordinate is constant, then the graph, or the graph of the line, is simply parallel to x-axis. Yes, Nahida, do you have any doubt here? You can ask. Yes, Nahida. Any doubt there?
No, ma'am, no doubt.
Okay. So, this was the equation of line which will be parallel to x-axis if your y-coordinate is constant. Now, let's see the next one. That is, line parallel to y-axis, or what will be the equation of line parallel to y-axis? Now, it is again of the same type. It is very easy. What will happen, students, here? Now, just by mistake, I have taken here 8, 0. It is 2, okay. Now, if you consider a few set of points here, A23, B24, C23, D2-1, E25. So, what happened here? In this, x coordinate is constant. What is that x coordinate? 2. And therefore, this equation will be definitely parallel to y-axis. And the equation of line will be x is equals to 2. That is, whatever the constant is, that is equals to will be the equation of a line. Just remember a few things. If x coordinate is constant, line will be parallel to y-axis. And if y-coordinate is constant, line will be parallel to x-axis. Clear? We can draw this one. The same type of that. Again, this coordinate system we are having, which is drawn on the graph paper. Now here, what we are saying now? We are saying that x coordinate is constant. What constant we have taken? 2. Suppose I take 2, 3. Where is 2? 2 is here. So it will meet somewhere here, 2, 3. Then suppose I take 2-7. Suppose 2-7. So here is -7. X coordinate is 2, y coordinate is 7, so this point will lie here. Suppose I take one more, 2-5, where is our 2? Here is our 2, and -5 is here, so it is going to meet here. Suppose I take one more point, 2-6, again 2 is here, this is 2, where is 6? 6 is here, so it will meet here. And if I draw a line passing through all this point, what will happen? That line will be definitely parallel to y-axis. Understood, students? What we have done? Simply have plotted the points and drawn a line connecting all the points. So that line is parallel to y-axis. So this will be the graph of a line parallel to y-axis, and the equation will be x is equals to 2. Problem. It is very, very easy, students. You have to just remember the simple tricks here. Now, let's see the graph of a linear equation. How to plot the graph of a linear equation on a graph paper. So, what is given here? Two equations are given to us. Draw the graph of the equations x is equals to 3 and y is equals to -4. What is saying? Draw the graph of a equations x is equals to 3 and y is equals to -4. Now, kya karenge? What are the steps here? This first step, I am not going to write the steps here. Whenever you are asked to draw any of the graph, you have to write it in a proper step. Firstly, you have to draw the step. If you are having a graph paper, graph book, you will see one page is of the graph paper and other page is a line paper. Means there you have to write. So what you are going to write on that paper? On that paper, you are going to write all the steps. But sometime you have to draw a table there. So that table or that steps we have to write on that blank page or line page, and the graph we are going to draw on the graph paper. So what are the steps here? So the first step will be simply draw xy coordinate. Second step, what will happen? I have to draw the graph of the equation x is equals to 3. X is equals to 3 means what I am going to do. Okay, I have taken the first step. I have drawn a graph paper. On this graph paper, I have drawn the xy system. Okay, x-axis, y-axis drawn, proper numberings are given to us. So what is that? X is equals to 3 means, for x is equals to 3, from this y-axis, I will measure a distance 3. Where is 3? Here is 3. So from this 3, draw a straight line passing from this 3. So I'm drawing a straight. So this is the line which is passing from this point 3. So this is your first equation or first graph, that is x is equals to 3. Next is what? Okay, what was the next? Next was y is equals to -4. Now let's draw y is equals to -4. Where is y is equals to -4? Here is y is equals to -4. So what will be the graph of this point? Simply, we are going to draw a line which will pass from this -4. So let's draw a line which will pass from this -4. So here, it is passing from this -4. So these are the two graphs. Actually, these were the two equations and we have to draw the graph of these two equations on a same graph paper. So these are the two lines and the point where it meets. The point where it meets, that is nothing but their intersection point. Suppose I am giving the name to this A. This point A is their intersection point. So what happens here? When this type of question is given to us, firstly, the first step will be draw xy axis. Second step, x is equals to 3. So from y axis, take a distance of 3, draw a line parallel to y axis from 3. This is your second step. Then third step, since y is equals to minus 4, take a distance of minus 4 from x axis to the below and draw a line parallel to x axis passing from minus 4. Write this in your own language. And next, denote the intersection point by any mallet, and simply write the coordinates of that point. What will the coordinates of this point? Can anyone say? X coordinate. Look here, this x coordinate. It is passing from 3. That means the x coordinate of A is 3. Then what will the y coordinate? Y coordinate. Look here, this is minus 4. So this is your y coordinate. So these are the coordinates of this point A. So these are the four steps which you have to complete whenever you have to draw any graph. Okay, the first three step and the last step, write the intersection point and write its coordinate. Yeah, it is very easy. Hope so all of you understood this very well. Now, we are given this question. Draw the graph of the equation. Earlier, whichever graph we had drawn, that was simply x is equals to 3, y is equals to minus 4. It is very easy. But if you look properly here, now the two variables are combined. This is actually linear equation. What is this? Linear equation. So in this equation, we have to draw this graph. How to draw this? You know very well, for plotting any graph, what we require? For plotting any graph, we require the numbers. But we don't have the numbers here. We are having only equation 2x minus y is equals to 0. So firstly, we have to convert this into that form. So let's start with the solution. So what we have taken? Given equation is 2x minus y is equals to 0. That means what we done? Y is equals to minus 2. Have you understood this? What I have done? I simply transfer this to y is equals to. I converted this equation as y is equals to. So minus y is equals to minus 2x. Just a minute. Yeah. Minus y is equals to minus 2x. So this will be converted like this way. Next. Now, whenever you have to plot a graph, we require at least four points. Okay, at least four coordinates. Means xy plane, at least we require four coordinates. So what we have taken? X, y, then xy coordinate system. Now, according to your choice, we have taken here y is equals to minus 2x. So that means the value of x will decide the value of y here. So according to your choice, take any values of x. I have taken here just 4 points. You can take 7, 8, 5, as much as you like. But at least 4 will be there. And don't take more than 4 because it will increase your time only. So here, what I have done? I have taken x is equals to 0. X is equals to 0 means in this equation. In this equation, I substituted the value of x is equals to 0. So what happened? Y is equals to minus 2 into 0. Anything multiplied by 0 is 0. So I get y also is equals to 0. That means if I write in the order pair xy, so it gets x coordinate 0, y coordinate is 0. So my first point is clear. Next, I am putting x is equals to minus 3. Where I am going to put x is equals to minus 3 in this equation. So what will happen? Minus 2 into minus 3. 2 3s are 6, minus minus plus. So I get y coordinate is equals to 6 here. Again, simply write down in this order pair, that is minus 3, 6. And finally, this next one. Again, as according to my choice, I take an x coordinate now is equals to 1. You can take here minus 1 also, 7, 3, whatever you want to take, you can take as of your choice. So here I take x is equals to 1. So put the value of x is equals to 1 again in this equation. So what will happen? Y is equals to minus 2 into 1. For x, I am substituted 1 here. So minus 2 into 1 is nothing but minus 2. Minus 2. So we get y coordinate is minus 2. So if I write in the order pair, I'm getting this x plus 1 minus 2. And nextly, again, according to my choice, I substitute x is equals to 2. Again, put this in this equation. So y is equals to minus 2 into 2 is nothing but minus 4. And therefore, in order pair, we have 2 minus 4. So we have got these 4 points. Now let's plot this 4 point on a graph paper. Since we have to draw the equation, we have to draw the graph of equation. Clear this? If you are given something like this one, just convert this into any variable. You can take either x is equals to also, or you can take either y is equals to also. After taking, converting that equation, draw a table like this where x, y, x prime. Choose the values of x according to your choice. Substitute the values in the equation we have reduced, and you will get the values of another coordinate, and simply write that in your coordinate system, that is order pair. Now completed. Now with the help of this, simply draw the graph on a graph paper. Okay, so here we are having this graph paper. On this graph paper, let's plot the point. So first point is 0 0, so where we will get that 0 0? Here. Where is 0 0? Here. That point will be here. I'm just writing here, okay? Just giving a dot here. 0 0. Then what is the next one? Next is minus 3 6. Right? Minus 3 6. So where is minus 3? Minus 3 is x coordinate. So here is minus 3. And 6 is somewhere here. So for my simplification, I'm taking 6 is here. Okay? Here is 6. So this is your next point. Suppose this is your point B. This was your point, suppose O. Then next point was 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2. Again, here is 1 minus 2 is here. Suppose this is your point C here. Clear? And what was the last point? 2 minus 4. 2 minus 4. Here is 2, where it's minus 4. Here is minus 4. Suppose this is your point D. Okay. Are the clear? So we have plotted all the 4 points. Now, we have just plotted the points. What we have to do? We have to draw. We have to simply connect all the points. Means we have to draw a line passing from all these points. So I'm drawing a line which will pass from all this point. If you look properly, otherwise it will pass from all the points here. And here was 6. So this line will be a straight line passing through all these points. So this is nothing but a graph of this equation. Always remember, for a linear equation, the graph will definitely a straight line. So this is a simple way of plotting the graphs. In the first step, we have to convert the equation in either one variable, either y is equals to or x is equals to. Then draw the table x, y and xy coordinate. Take the values of x as your choice, any values of x, and put the values in the given equation. Find out the values of y so that you will get the values of xy coordinate. And once you got the coordinates, take a graph paper, draw x axis, draw y axis, plot the points on that, and then simply connect all the points here. Okay. Hope so you understood this very well. Up to this, anyone having any doubt? Kisi ko doubt hai yahan tak? They can ask. Yes, any doubt in this question? How to plot the graph? Yes, Srinath. Yes, Srinath. Srinath, you can unmute yourself. Okay, no. Anyone else having any doubt up to this? No? Okay. Up to this, no doubt. Very good. Now let's see the next. Okay. This much for this is only this. What we are learning here, we are learning how to draw the graphs on an axis, how to plot the graphs. Now let's see few types of question which can be asked for 1 marks. Now look here. Who can answer this type of question? I'm simply going to ask you a few questions here, which can be, these are the MCQ questions which are asked in the question number 1A. So let's try to answer this question. So what is the form of coordinate of a point on the x-axis? What it says, what is the form of coordinates of a point on x-axis? Means if a point is lying on x-axis, so what will be its coordinate? What will be its x coordinate? What will be its y coordinate? Can anyone answer this question? Yes, anyone? Anyone? No? Okay. What is here? If a line is lying on, point is lying on x-axis, definitely if, okay, Aman, very good. Okay, Aman, you want to answer or not? You have put down your hand. No? Okay, no problem. If it is lying on x-axis, that means definitely we are having x-coordinate. X-axis. Lying on x-axis, so we are having x-coordinate. But what about y-coordinate? Whether we'll get a y-coordinate there? Definitely no. Since the point is lying on x-axis, since it is lying on x-axis, we are getting x-coordinate. I mean, this can happen. Either first will come, third will come, or fourth will come. This will not come. Why? Because here x-coordinate is zero. But since it is lying on x-axis, we will get x-coordinate. But what since it is lying on x-axis, your y-coordinate will be equals to 0. So your answer is C, that is A, 0. A can be any number from minus infinity to plus infinity. But your y-coordinate will be definitely equals to 0 since it is lying on x-axis. Okay? Now let's see the second one. Any point on the line y is equals to x, that means your x coordinate and y coordinate, both will be same here. So who can answer this question? Kravat can answer this question. Mayang, x coordinate and y coordinate. Okay, so what happened here? Both the coordinates are same. That means, if you look in the options, first is AA, 0A, A0, A minus A. This will not happen. Why? Because both are the same, X and Y. So your option will be this one, AA. Now let's see third one. What is the equation of the x-axis? What will be the equation of x-axis? You know very well, on x-axis, you will get Y coordinate is 0, that will be your equation will be y is equals to 0. Okay, on x-axis, y coordinate will be 0. Next, in which quadrant does the point minus 4, minus 3 lie? We don't have to consider the number, just consider the sign. Both the signs are negative. So where we get both the negative, we'll get this in quadrant number 3. So it is 3rd. Next one, what is the nature of the line which include this point? Now we are given few points here. So what will be the nature? Look here. Minus 5, 5, 6, 5, minus 3, 5, 0, 5. If you look properly, its y coordinate is constant. Y coordinate is constant means this line, whether it will pass from the origin, parallel to y-axis, parallel to x-axis, or none of this. Yes, Manasvi, you raise your hand. Can you, Faisal or Faraz, what is this? Faisal, can you answer this? You can unmute yourself.
Y-axis.
The answer is C.
y-axis. Okay, let me see. Okay, whether it will parallel to y-axis? No, students. It is y-coordinate is constant, so it will parallel to x-axis. Look here, y-coordinate is constant. That means the line will be something like this way. So this will be parallel to x-axis. Next one, which of the points lie in the fourth quadrant? From this, which will lie in fourth quadrant? So now you know very well, in fourth quadrant, your x-coordinate is positive and your y-coordinate is negative. So where you see plus minus sign? Okay, fourth student has raised your hand. So Shivam, Sakshi, okay. Yes, Shivam. Yes, Shweta, you can answer. Shweta Yadav?
Yes, miss.
Bolo beta, which of the points will lie in fourth quadrant?
Miss B1, Q and R.
Q and R. Yes, yes, yes. Q and R. Positive. Q is positive, yes. Okay, mute yourself. Q is positive. And y is negative. Same way, x is positive, y is negative. So these two are lying. Any other? Definitely others will not lie. Please mute yourself. Who is this? Shweta, mute yourself. Okay, what we are going to see here? We simply see which x coordinate is positive, where we will get x positive and y negative. Accordingly that we have decided that this will lie in quadrant number 4th here. Sorry, the quadrant number 4, that is point Q and R. Okay, now let's see one more question. Now some of the points are shown in this figure. So with the help of it, we have to answer the given question. So write the coordinates of Q and R. So let's write the coordinates of Q, R and R, where is Q? First will be x coordinate and next will be y coordinate. For the Q, I'm writing for Q. Where is Q? This x coordinate is minus 2. So x coordinate will be minus 2, comma, what is y coordinate? Is y coordinate is 2. So coordinates of Q are minus 2 plus 2. Next, who will say for R? Yes, Sakshi Maurya. Yes, Sakshi. What will the coordinates of R?
The coordinates of R will be 4 and minus 1.
Okay, very good. Coordinates of R is 4 minus 1. Then coordinates of T and M. Just a minute. Yes, who is this? Sakshi Tiwari. Yes, beta, coordinates of T and M?
Ma'am, the coordinates of T is 0 and minus 1 and the coordinates of M is 3 and 0.
Okay, very good. The coordinates of T are minus 1, 0 and coordinates of M are 3, 0. Sorry, it is 0, minus 1. Very good. Now, next is what? Which points lie in the third coordinate? So, which is lying on the third coordinate?
S point S
is lying on the third coordinate. Very good. Next one, which are the points whose x and y coordinates are equal? Which is that? Whose x and y coordinate are equal? This is point O. Is x and y coordinate both are zero. So, this is the point who are having both the coordinates are equal. Okay. Up to this clear, everyone? Anyone having any doubt? Is koi doubt hai tak?
No, miss.
No? Okay, very good. So, we'll stop here. If you just go through all these questions, very easy. Tomorrow, we'll see the next part. Okay, sir, I have completed. Sir? Hello, sir, I have completed the part.